This conference will now be recorded.
Okay guys, so here in this session, I'm going to continue basic settings. Okay, so now here, basic settings, what exactly we are going to do, which settings we are going to do. So we'll start one by one. And majorly, if you talk about basic settings, then these are the settings which we must have to do. Okay, these are the settings which we must have to do. I already explained yesterday, during yesterday class, like we have to set up company code, business areas and all, because whenever you are going to post a transactions, then there'll be a common questions, whether it is for Tata Motor or Tata Steel, again in Tata Motor also, let's suppose whether it is for manufacturing or but for service or XYZ, whatever is there. Even apart from this, if you're going to post a transaction, then there will be a question for which fiscal year, for which financial year, for which, you know, period in the sense, for which month, isn't it? So this is what here we are having. First of all, we have to define posting period variant. We have to define fiscal year variant, okay, financial year and posting period, everything. Now, I'll tell you guys generally. So here, okay, so we have to define posting period, okay, posting period variant. Why to define this posting period variant, and what is this variant, guys? I'll tell you. Okay, what is this variant all about? That also I'll explain, because there will be questions: posting period variant, fiscal year variant, field status variant. So one by one we'll explain, but we'll let you know this. What is this variant? So now here, let's suppose generally this is, which month is this? Yeah, it's October. October means 10th month. Okay, if we calculate from January, okay. So now October is 10th month. Now here, what is happening, guys? So here, let's suppose, okay, I'll do one thing. First of all, I'll explain this posting period variant, and then I'll let you know what is the use of this variant. So posting period variant, guys, what is happening here? First of all, we have to define a posting period variant. Okay, our company code is TM02. Okay, this is our company code, TM02. It means Tata Motor. Now we have to define a posting period variant. Why to define a posting period variant? So I'll let you know. Generally, posting period variant we have to define, because against this posting period variant, we have to open and close the period. Why we are going to open and close the period? So guys, it's a control. Which kind of control? I'll tell you. Now, what I said, just assume that before this SAP Tata Motor was using, just they were maintaining all these things in a different registers they used to maintain. So now here, while maintaining these registers and all, end users were having lots of privilege. What kind of privilege they used to have, guys? I'll tell you. Say for example, there was a guy, Mr. A, okay? And what he did, he actually is maintaining, you know, certain, what to say, this is 2018, right? So that guy I'm talking about in 2017. Let's suppose in 2017, they are maintaining the registers and all. So this guy received one invoice. Invoice means, let's suppose, vendor invoice, okay? So now what is happening, guys? As per accounting rules or principle, the transaction must be recorded whenever it is taking place. So it means if that guy has received an invoice on, let's suppose that guy has received an invoice just on this date, okay? Or is like, let's suppose he has received that on 25th and 09, 2018. Okay, so he was supposed to record, or he was supposed to record this invoice related entries in the respective books of account on that particular day itself. But he forgotten, or else he was in hurry because he received this invoices maybe in evenings through couriers on whatever the way is there. Now he forgotten and that guy left. Okay, we'll post this, in the sense we'll record this tomorrow. Now tomorrow what is happening? He forgotten to post this invoice, and that invoice, let's suppose, was there on the desk somewhere, you know, he kept under files and all, and he forgot it. Now what is happening, guys? Now almost he forgotten for a month. It was there inside itself. Now what is happening? After a month, let's suppose, once the whichever the invoices are getting posted, after a certain period we have to make payment to the vendors. Okay, because we have purchased something from vendors, so we are liable to pay. Now what will happen, guys? After a month, vendor is going to ask these things from account payable department, that guys, I have sent an invoice on so and so date worth of this much, and still I have not received payment. Then what will happen? Then account payable team is going to ask the concerned person that you are posting the invoices, so this vendor had sent an invoice, and what is the status of that? Then that guy is going to realize, oh my god, I made a mistake. That invoice I kept somewhere and I could not post it somewhere. I could not post it, which is why the payment got delayed and all. So now what will happen? So account payable team, everybody just sitting together, all are just like your friend itself. Immediately he is going to take the previous month registers. Now right now, after 1 month, means it is almost 25th 10 2018. So now what is happening? We have, like, after 1 month means we went to the next month already. So now what is happening, guys? Now that guy is going to rush to his desk and all. He started searching, where is the invoice? He found the invoice, and let's suppose now what is happening, since they are maintaining the registers and all, so simply he is going to adjust this entry on some of the page. Okay, on which month registers? On September month register, simply he is going to adjust this entry somewhere, and then somebody, his colleague, is going to release the payment. They are going to release the payment, in the sense checks or whatever the things are there. This is how they are able to manage. Okay, so now what will happen? There is no problem, because this transaction, this is simply he has inserted these things. But guys, management will never accept such kind of mistakes and all, or such kind of negligence. Why? Because this negligence, in the sense, like, this kind of carelessness, management will never accept, because this is not the correct way of practice. The invoice was received in previous month, and it is going to be posted in 10th month, October month. Okay, this is not 18, actually it should be 17, guys. Because why I'm giving example of 17, because just assume that till 17 SAP is not implemented. SAP is going to be implemented in 2018. That's what I'm giving example of previous year. So till previous year, these guys were having very much too much enjoyments and all. Even if they made the mistakes and all, no one knows that somebody has made the mistake, except 3-4 people, whoever is there in the team. So everybody is going to cooperate, because they know that even those people also make the mistakes and all. But they are not going to inform the management people. The managers will not know that somebody has made the mistake. But why management do not allow such kind of practice? Because this is not a good practice. Once the external audit is taking place, or whatever the audit is taking place, so what is happening, that auditors are going to check, you know, their books of account randomly. They are going to pick certain transactions and all, and they will check that, okay, where is the supporting document on this, on which date you have received the invoices, on which date you are making payments and all. Okay, so now by chance, if somebody has select this line item with this invoice itself, then what will happen? They'll ask, like, okay, this invoice was received on this date, and it is posted on 25, in the sense, like, it was received in September month. again, they will see that, okay, it is posted in September month itself, there is no issues. But guys, I'll tell you generally what is happening. Whenever any invoice is going to be posted, then we have to deduct certain taxes also. Okay, TDS, let's suppose TDS is going to be deducted. Okay, so simply that guy has adjusted this entry here in September month, but where is the TDS? Okay, if somebody is going to calculate, if the auditor is going to calculate the total TDS, then let's suppose if this amount is total 1000 rupees and TDS percentage is 10%. So now there is a margin of 100 rupees, in the sense 100 rupees will be the 100 rupees, the total amount, if they're going to calculate the total TDS on the total amount of this September month, let's suppose in September month, originally how much they have posted? They have posted the total amount of, total amount they have posted, how much? 10,000, September. Okay, now in October month, this guy realized his mistake and somewhere he is going to adjust that entry of 1,000. So how much total amount? 11,000. But in September, at the month end, what is happening, whichever the tax, whatever this accounting team is there, they're going to calculate the TDS and all, and they found like on 10,000 was the original amount. So on that, how much TDS is going to be deducted? 10% is 1,000 rupees. Okay. So they have deposited or they have submitted whatever the like tax department is there, they're going to remit how much? They're going to make payment of how much? 1,000 rupees only the tax. But now here the total amount become 11,000 rupees because in the next month this guy has inserted one more entry, so it become 11,000 rupees, whereas the total tax deposit is 1,000 only, whereas it was supposed to be 1,100. So the auditor is going to find out these things, right? There are lots of way, guys, by which these people are going to find out such kind of malpractices. In the sense, this kind of practice is not accepted, and the companies also will have certain kind of impact on their reputations and all, because of that management will not allow such kind of practices. Because of one carelessness, what is happening, these people are going to catch such kind of mistakes and all, and they're going to ask the questions why it has happened. Okay, and the government of India or any countries, whichever the, you know, countries, governments are there, they're very much, you know, cautious about the taxes and all. So now here management will not allow such kind of practices. But generally what is happening, these guys are not going to inform the managements and all. So management will come to know only, or managers will come to know only, if the auditor is going to find out such kind of mistakes during audits and all, then they are going to escalate these things that we got such kind of several transactions which has taken place in your organizations. It means you guys are making fraud, you are just stealing the taxes and all, isn't it? Now, so these things are happening if they are maintaining the registers and all. Even let's suppose if they are using some small ERP, in that ERP is also, there is no such kind of controls and all. But guys, in SAP, there is a very, you know, like these kind of controls are there. How it is going to be controlled, I'll let you know. In SAP, this is going to be controlled. Why? Because generally what is happening, this is your company code TM02. And we are going to create a posting period variant, that is T, let's suppose this code I have given, okay, Tata Motor posting period variant. This is the code I have given. Okay, generally what is happening, I say is like, whenever you guys are going to set up any configurations, better to give the same code, whichever code we have given for company code here, the same code we are going to give here also. But anyway, this is the posting period variant which I have created. Okay, here is our company code and we have created a posting period variant TMPV. Now against this posting period variant, what is happening, guys, we are having a functionality to open or close the period. Okay, to open or close the period, it means what is happening now, the same thing is going to be repeated by Mr. A in 2018, where the SAP is implemented. So he has been very much habituated of making such kind of mistakes, and he knows that easily I'm going to escape, management will not come to know. So he has made the same similar you know, mistakes here in 2018 also. He is doing the same stupidity, in the sense because of his carelessness and all, again the same thing is happening. But right now, guys, there is no other ERP, there is no registers and all. Now what is happening? SAP, let's suppose, got implemented. So in SAP, what is happening? We are having company code, and we have created a posting period variant. That variant is going to be linked with the company code. And against this posting period variant, we are having functionality to open and close the period. Open and close the period in the sense, let's suppose this is October means, let's suppose this is our 10th period. Okay, October means, let's suppose this is our 10th period. Just assume here, we are going to follow the calendar year right now. Once I start this fiscal year variant, there I'm going to explain the details. Right now, October means 10th period. So here, what is happening? We are having functionality in September month. What is happening, guys? We will be having like, this is called 09/2018 to 09/2018. Okay, and this is called month. Here, this is called from period, and this is year, and here to period, and this is year again, year. Okay, so now here, period means month. So for generally in September month, this guy has made mistake. September month, he has not posted his transactions. So once we entered in October month, then he realized that he has made the mistake because somebody has reminded that what is the status of so and so invoices. Now this guy realized that, oh my god, I forgotten to post this invoice. So in October month, what is happening, guys? Once we enter in October, this period is going to be September period is going to be closed. Now your management is going to open period number 10. So what is happening, guys? Whenever this fellow is going to post the transaction, then he has to post this transaction in the previous month only. He current month he cannot post. Why? Because the invoice was received in the previous month. So he must have to, in order to hide his mistake, he must have to post this invoice in previous month. So now this guy is going to post invoice in previous month. He is going to give the posting date 25/09/2018. So now the moment he post this transactions, in the sense the moment he give this date, then system will find out, in background system is going to check what is the company code. So of course it is going to be posted against Tata Motor. Now system is going to find out against Tata Motor which posting period variant has been linked. So it is TMPV. Okay, now again in background system is going to find out against TMPV which period is open. System found that period number 10 is open and this posting is happening for period number 9. So period number 9 is not open. It means it is closed. Management has already closed the period. Now system is going to throw an error that posting is not possible in the previous period. Now what will happen, guys? Whatever the enjoyment is there, that is gone. Now this fellow is going to be caught immediately because there is no any other solution. He cannot post this transaction in the previous period because previous period is closed. Okay, so now this guy is going to approach to the manager and manager is going to give him a very big lecture. And after that, what will happen? Management is going to open the period number 09. For let's suppose few minutes or maybe half an hour or whatever, they will, you know, teach him a lesson and all, and then after they will say that, okay, I'm going to open this period for half an hour. You post this entry, but accept your mistake. You have to mention somewhere in the narration field, you are going to specify in our narration that, okay, due to certain reason we were not able to, like certain narration they are going to specify. So even during audit, what is happening? If auditor found this mistake, they are going to ignore this kind of one or two transactions. Okay, this may happen. So now previous period is open, so this guy will be able to post this transaction. So this is the major control of posting period variant, guys. This is the major control of posting period. Okay. Now, I said, like, why to create this posting period as a variant? What is the use of variant? So, guys, now I'll tell you. Variant is a reusable transaction. Sorry, variant is a reusable configuration steps or transactions, whichever you say. Why? Because we have created a posting period variant, TMPV. Okay. Now, we have done this. We have done this implementation for Tata Motor. This TMPV we have assigned. Now, if the Tata Steel is also, if you are going to do the rollout for Tata Steel, then for Tata Steel also, we have to create a posting period variant. So instead of, let's suppose for Tata Steel, we have given TS02 as a company code we have set up. Second time, let's suppose if you are going to do the rollout. So now for Tata Steel also, if the Tata Steel is also following the Jan to December fiscal year itself, it means for Tata Steel also, the same periods are going to work out. So instead of creating a new posting period variant, same posting period variant is going to be assigned against Tata Motor, Tata Steel also. So now if we open and close this period, let's suppose if the 09 is open for Tata Motor, even it got open for Tata Steel also. Okay, if we have closed the 09, it is going to be closed for Tata Steel also. Okay, so it's not like that if you're having 100 company code, and if all the company codes are following the same financial year, in the sense similar financial year, then what is happening? If we create 100 post, instead of creating 100 posting period variant, we create only one posting period variant, and we are going to assign the same posting period variant against all the 100 company code. And at the month end, we are going to close the previous period, and we are going to open the new period. So once you close the previous period, then it is going to be closed for all the company codes. Once you are going to open the new period, that is going to be open for all the company code. Okay. So variant means that can be, it's a kind of transactions. This is called reusable transactions. It means once post, you have created one posting period variant, but that can be assigned to several company code. Don't be confused, guys. Once we proceed further, you guys will be able to understand this logic very easily. Right now, I'm not shown practically here, theoretically itself. I am explaining. So now I'll show you how to set up posting period variant. Okay, double click on here and let me give my user ID and password. Let me log in first, so that I'll let you know, guys, how to create this posting period variant. So how to set up posting period variant, guys? The transaction code is, I think, OBBO. This is the transaction code. Let me try it. OBBO. This is the transaction code by which we have to create the posting period variant. Look at here. Now, so click on new entry and define your posting period variant. So guys, instead of giving a different code, better to use the same code which we have given against company code. Okay. Why? Because so that it will be easy for you guys to remember. Okay. Here posting period variant, let's suppose we have given a different code. Okay. Where it is posting this code I have given. Company code is having to different code. During field status variant against, we are going to give a different code. So this much code is very difficult to remember. That is why initially I said to keep the same code. And even in real time also, if we are having only one company code, then most likely people are going to do the same kind of things. So let's suppose I'm going to create a variant. For that, I'm going to give TM02 itself. A code I'm going to give TM02. There is no restrictions that you also have to do the same thing. Whichever code you want to give, you can give. The length of that code will be 4-digit only, and apart from this, that code will be either numeric, alphanumeric, or alphabetic. Anything you can give here. Now, and here we can give the name of posting period variant, press enter and save it. So once you save, system is going to suggest you the transport request number. Now what I said, you have to press enter, save this changes on the same TR number until unless you are going to understand the logic behind this transport request number, which will come. Still, there are lots of time to come. Okay, so now here, what I've done, I have created a posting period variant, but this posting period variant I have created for Tata Motor that I know, you know, but SAP doesn't know. How SAP will come to know, because SAP is not having any linkages with our minds, and also how SAP will come to know, SAP will come to know only if we assign this posting period variant with our company code. So use transaction codes slash NOBBP. This is the transaction code by which we are going to assign this variant with the company code. Press enter and click on position to find out where is our company code, because there are lots of company code. So give your company code TM02 and press enter. Look at here. Now here we are going to give our variant which we have created just now, TM02, press enter and save it. And once again, press enter. So what we have done, guys, we have created a posting period variant, that is TM02 itself, and we have linked with our company code. Now it's time to open and close the period. Okay, open close period. How to open and close the period? So guys, for that we have to use a transaction code slash NOB52. So whichever two transaction code I told you guys, okay, I explained you guys, that is those both transaction code, like I have created posting period variant and I have assigned with the company code. Okay, so that is only one time activity, only once we have to do. After that, not at all, even whole life also. Okay, once we have created posting period variant and once you assign with the company code, nothing else apart from this we are going to do. Okay, that is only one time settings. But open and close posting period is a regular activity. It means at every month end we are going to close the previous period and we are going to open the current period. So this is a recurring transaction, you can say recurring, you know what to say, things you can say, that it is always going to, every month end we have to close the previous period and we have to open the new period. Now how to open and close the period? So first of all, select the first one, guys. Here also there are lots of things to know. I'll explain one by one, but right now let me do one thing. Select here, what you have to do, select the first one. Okay, select the first one. Even there are lots of other logic also, but right now select the first one and click on copy. Okay, now what we have to do, give your variant TM02, which variant we have created, TM02, and then there is nothing we are going to give here from account to account. If you don't give from account to account, it means this posting period, open and close posting period, whatever the period is going to be open, that is valid for all the account, customer, vendor, GL, everything. Now here, so I've given variant TM02. From account to account, nothing I have given. Look at here, from period one. So we are, let's suppose this is October, right? So October means which period? So right now I'll just do one thing, guys. Okay, October means 10th period. I'll do your 10th period 2018, and here also 10th period 2018. What is the use of these things, that I'll let you know. Press enter and save it. So now guys, what is happening? This is the case. Okay, now here, if manager is now that I one second I'll come on this story, guys. And what is the story? So Mr. A has made mistake, and later on he tried all the way and he was not able to post the transaction. Why? Because the previous month is already closed here. Okay, 10th period is only open. So now this guy, ultimately, he or she approached to project manager and realized the mistake. And then project manager, not project manager, whoever the manager is there. So that guy is going to reach the manager and realize the mistake. Now manager is going to open the previous period also. How? 09 and save it. It means now here what is happening, guys? Now September month is also open, October month is also open. September month is also open, October month is also open. Okay, so now this guy is going to approach his desk and happily is going to post the transaction. Now there is a twist in this story, guys. There is a twist in the sense, I'll just do one thing. There is a twist. What kind of twist? This A is there and he made the mistake. Okay, he is having two clever friend B and C. This guy is having two clever friend B and C. So what is happening, guys? This A has explained his concern, because one day back or 2 days back, this A has tried several times to post the transaction and he was unable to make it. Okay, so what is happening? He already narrated his mistake and he told B and C that, guys, I have stuck somewhere. Generally, there was a previous month transaction which I was unable to post. Now what is happening? I am trying to post this transaction in the previous month period only, but system is throwing an error that previous month is already closed. So you are not allowed to post the transactions. These kind of errors we are going to face. Now what is happening, guys? This B and C, strictly they have suggested, don't do such kind of state experiment. Just approach to manager and realize your mistake, in the sense you accept your mistake and tell him to open the previous period. Okay, look at here the way I opened here previous period. Tell him to open the previous period. So this A is there, this innocent guy. Actually, he said, yes, I'm also thinking the same because I'm not having any other options. Okay, so I'm going to approach the manager and then let him open the previous period and then we'll post the transaction. But I'll tell you guys, even these two clever or cunning guys, they have also made the similar mistakes. They have also made the similar mistakes. And now what is happening? What these guys has thought? Okay, already this fellow is having the same problem. So let him approach to the manager. Let him listen all the lectures. What will happen? Manager is going to say, you know, what to say, scold him like anything. And after scolding, the management or manager is going to open the previous period. So the moment previous period is going to be open for this fellow, even we are also going to post our transaction. Okay, this is the thought. Now here, so this guy A has approached to the manager, and manager has opened the previous period. This guy happily came to his desk and he has posted the transaction. The transaction got posted. But even let's suppose the similar mistake these guys has also done. It could be a different date, but I'm just keeping same date here. Let's suppose there could be like different date will be there. Transactions could be different. Okay. So now, if these guys are going to post the transaction, system is not allowing them to post the transaction. System is saying that previous period is already closed. You guys cannot be able to post the transactions. Okay. They're having a huge headache that how come it possible that this fellow is able to post the transaction, but we are not able to post the transactions. So I'll tell you guys, managers become manager after having some experience. So they knows that there are certain cunning fellow who is not approaching me, but still other people have also made the similar mistake. Okay, they are waiting to these fellows are waiting for the to open the previous period, and once I open, then this guy is going to post the transactions, Mr. A is going to post the transactions, but remaining whoever the cunning fellows are there, they will come to know and they are also going to post their transactions. So one guy has accepted his mistake, but remaining other people are still, they are going to become honest only. Okay, so what manager has done, that manager is going to let me see whether this screen is there or gone, because if I don't do any activities, then after 5 minutes or 6 minutes or 7 minutes, automatically this screen is going to be closed. Okay, the connection is going to be broken, so we have to log in once again. It happens in real time also, but the duration will be more in real time. Generally after 20-30 minutes the screen will be logged out automatically. Now here what manager is doing, guys, manager has done nothing. This 10th period is there, your 10th period is, it means manager has not done any changes in from period 1. Manager is going to change it, do apply a changes here from period 2. Here what manager is doing, your manager is going to open period number 9, 2018, and again period number 9, 2018. So guys, if you look at here, period number 10 is also open and period number 9 is also open. Till now there is no problem, but what manager has done, manager is going to create an authorization group. Let's suppose this is called, last one is called authorization group. Manager will not create, guys, this is the work of technical consultant. They will do, they will create this authorization group and they are going to assign the this user ID of Mr. A. Okay, so what manager has done, manager has created an authorization group that is XYZ, and against this XYZ manager has assigned the user ID of Mr. A. Against this authorization group, manager has assigned the user ID of Mr. A. So now what is happening, guys? Now the 10th period is open for everybody. 10th period is open for everybody, whoever is working for Tata Motor. But once this, okay, now what is happening, guys? Now whenever the A, Mr. A is going to post the transactions, system is going to check whether 9th period is open or not. Okay, system found that 9th period is not open, 10th is only open. Now system is also going to check in from period 2 also. System found, oh, in from period 2, this 9th period is open, but there is one conditions. Here conditions apply is there, here star mark is there. What is this condition applies? That this from period 2 is open against this authorization group, guys, XYZ. So in background system is going to check against this authorization group, which user ID has been linked. So user ID of Mr. A is linked. So what is happening? System is not going to throw any error whenever this A is going to post a transaction in the previous period. Okay, because for him, permission granted. But what about this fellow? Whenever B is trying to post, once again system is going to search what is the posting period for this fellow. System came to know that he is trying to post this transactions in September month. It means 9th period. Once again, system is going to check here in OB52 in background. Okay, that okay. Now for what is the posting period open? So here 10th period open, 9th period is not open. But in from period 2, 9th period is open. But again, this 9th period is open for against this authorization group. Okay, so now against this authorization group, what is happening, guys? Only one user ID is linked. It means the permission is granted to only one fellow. Apart from this A, no one is having permission to post the transaction against period number 9. So now what is happening, guys? Now this too much clever people, the one by one, these people are also going to approach to the manager's cabin and they are also going to accept their mistakes. Sir, we have also done the mistake. Kindly open the period for us also. Now these guys are going to listen the double lectures and all. So what I mean to say, guys, why I have narrated this story, these kind of controls are there. There are other controls also, guys, that I'll explain you guys, that I'll let you know. So if you talk about the creation and the, what to say, this posting period variant and all, it's a matter of 2 minutes only. Okay. But how much time it has taken? Almost it has taken close to 50 minutes or 55 minutes, one topic, isn't it? If you watch that YouTube videos and all, people are going to create this posting period variant in two lines. People are going to explain these things and they are going to let you know how to create this posting period variant. But guys, it's not like that. We have to learn how to create posting period variant. 1,000 candidates are coming for interviews and all. Everybody knows how to create the posting period variant. But what about this functionality which I'm explaining, isn't it? Those you need to understand, this is how you guys are going to be unique. Out of 100, if I say like 5 candidates are there, who is going to be selected? Those 5 candidates are having these kind of knowledge and all. Okay. So don't be in hurry. Just try to understand the concepts and all. Okay. So now, this is the use of posting period variant. Posting period variant is going to control. Posting period variant is going to control what? It is going to have a control on the posting side. I have already explained here. Look at here. Here it is. Okay. Posting period variant. I'll have to bring here. Okay. Posting period variant. These are the transaction code. So posting period variant controls the posting of a transaction for a specific period. Okay. It is going to control the posting of a transaction for a specific period. Okay, here I have given this code, could be like here TM10. Instead of that, we can give, like, let's suppose we are given TM02. Okay, and from period 1 to 2, instead of that, we have given, like, let's suppose 10th, and here also 10th. It means the transaction is going to be posted. Transaction is going to be posted against for October month, all the transactions are. System will allow to post the transactions. Previous month transactions are not going to be allowed. Okay, so these kind of controls are there, and this is how now what will happen. Now what will happen, guys? Now the guy who used to do lots of carelessness earlier, now these people are going to be too much careful, and they know that if we are going to repeat the same mistake, now this time manager is not going to leave us alive. Okay, in the sense, like, they are going to scold them like anything, isn't it? So now next time these guys are going to be extra careful. And I'll let you know, guys, why whenever, if you talk about the SAP implementations and all, if we talk about, like, let's suppose I said, like, we are having the sales and marketing team and these people are going to give presentations to the higher level managers only. Why? Because if they are going to explain such kind of control to the end user people, ground level people, are they going to accept SAP in their organizations? Immediately people are going to sit on the strike. No, we are very much happy with the previous ERP or in this, like, register era itself. We don't want SAPs and all, because they know that these kind of controls are there. So all the commands will be there in the hand of managers only. So guys, what is happening? This is why these people are going to they're going to give the presentations to higher level management, because they are the key decision maker people. And once they come to know that these kind of controls are there in SAPs and all, of course, these people are going to be too much impressed. So this is the one control which I have explained. Even later also, I'll explain. There are lots of other topics because we have started our session just now. So this is what the use of posting period variant, guys. Okay. So still we are having lots of other topics also. Fiscal year variant, field status variant. So now that is going to be explained in next session. Okay, so that's all in this session, guys, and that's all for today. Generally, let me see whether I have now these things are not possible. Why? Because I'll just do one thing. Let me check. Okay, the connection got broken because it's already more than 5 minutes. So it will happen, guys, for you guys also. If you don't perform any activities in the system for 5-6 minutes, then automatically it is going to be log out. So you have to log in once again. Okay, you have to log in once again, click that here. And in this case, you have to click on here, the first one, and then press enter. Now, as I said, your last 15 transaction codes are going to be recorded here. So select OV52 and press enter. Now, click on position and check our posting period variant, that is TM02. Let me check whether I have saved this or not. Yes, I have saved. Yes, I have saved. Okay. So here, what will happen? Let's suppose I'm going to open this 10th period deal right now. Okay. Again, tomorrow it is going to be changed because once I start the fiscal year variant, then we are going to discuss lots of things. So this is the use of posting period variant, guys. Here we are going to, if we open this 10th period, we have open wins, that is open for everybody. If you're going to open here, let's suppose 9th period, if I have given 2018, okay, like here also 9th, 2018, then this 9th period is also open for everybody. If you don't give here authorization group, then this is also open for everybody. So if 9th period, instead of opening here, why to make this here? We are going to make it here itself. Here we can make it 9th period, right? And we are going to remove these things. What is the use of this one? Either if you are going to give the authorization group, that control is there. Or sometime recently, one of my students was there, not recently, I think few months back, one of my students was there. That guy said like, so there is a requirement that, let's suppose August period is already open. They are saying that, you know, don't open July, June supposed to be open. It means open the August period and open the June period. July supposed not to be open. So in that case, what is happening, guys? August means, let's suppose 8th. So 8th, 2018, August is open for everybody. And now they are saying that July supposed not to be open, June supposed to be open for everybody. So here, June got opened. Okay. So this is how, what is happening. We are having two posting period we have opened. August is also open, June is also open, but July is not open. Okay. Now, if you say that I want to open like August supposed to be open, June supposed to be open, and April supposed to be open. This is not going to happen, guys. This is what the, this much we are having the options and all. If they are saying that, okay, April supposed to be open. So what will happen in that case? We'll say that, okay, you post the transactions, whichever is there from this June month and all. And once you guys are able to post the transactions, then we are going to open April here itself. This is how it is happening. Okay. So there are lots of things which we can explore, guys, but right now we are having lots of other settings also. Once we do the basic settings and all, then we'll have to do some basic setting for GLs. And after that, we will be able to post the transactions. Once I post the transactions, once again, I'm going to explain the logic so that you guys will be having perfect understanding. Okay. So that's all in this posting period, guys. I'm not going to save these things. Okay. Here, make it no. Those things I'm not going to save. Simply have what I've done. Okay, so I have opened a 10th period only. This period number 2, I have not done anything. Okay, now, so that's all in this session, guys. That's all for posting period and that's all for today. Tomorrow, I'm going to start the fiscal year variant. Once again, I'll explain what is the logic behind that. And so that's all for today, guys. That's all in this session.